we want to find all of the zeros, or roots, of the given degree 3 polynomial function. We want to start by finding the rational zeros of the function, and to do this we're often asked to make a list of all the possible rational zeros. And all of the possible rational zeros of a polynomial function are formed by the ratio of the factors of the constant term, in this case negative 78, to the factors of the leading coefficient, which in this case is just positive 1. So let's start by listing all the factors of negative 78, all the factors of 1, and then we'll find the ratio of the two lists. Finding all the factors of 78, or negative 78, isn't all that easy, so let's take a look at the prime factorization of 78, because this will help us find all the factors. Well, I know 78 is 2 times 39, and 39 is equal to 3 times 13. So we can use the prime factorization to list all the factors of negative 78. Well, of course, plus or minus 1 would be a factor, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3. Well, if 2 and 3 are factors, then so would 6, so plus or minus 6. Then we have plus or minus 13. Now we're not done, because 2 times 13 would also give us factors of 78. So we have plus or minus 26. And then 3 times 13 would be 39. So we also have factors plus or minus 39. Then of course plus or minus 78. The only factors of 1 are plus or minus 1. Now if we form a ratio of these factors, since our denominator only contains the factors of plus or minus 1, the possible rational zeros would just be the factors of negative 78. So here's the list of possible rational zeros. Again, because the leading coefficient is just 1, this leaves us with the factors of negative 78. Now at this point, we could use trial and error and substitute these values into the function to see which would make the function equal to 0, but that would take a lot of time. I like to use the graph of the function to find the real rational zeros. And because we're looking for the x values that make the function, or y equal to 0, the x-intercepts of this function will give us the real zeros, and then from there we can find which ones are rational. So if we graph this function, it's going to look like this, and the first thing we should notice is there's only one x-intercept, which means there's only one real zero, and notice our x-intercept is positive 6, therefore, positive 6 is a real rational zero of the given function. So let's go ahead and write that down. We know we're going to have three zeros, and we now know one of them is x equals 6. Now, I say three zeros because it's a degree 3 polynomial. We know it'll have three zeros as long as we count multiplicity, because it's a degree 3 polynomial function. Now, the next connection we need to make is that if x equals 6 is a zero of this function, then x minus 6 would have to be a factor of the function. So we can rewrite the original function as f of x equals a factor of x minus 6 times another degree 2 factor, which we can find by dividing the original polynomial by x minus 6, or we can perform synthetic division using x equals 6. Let's go ahead and use synthetic division. So we'll have a 6 over here in the corner. We're going to list the coefficients of the original polynomial function, which are 1, negative 12, 49, and negative 78. Now, because we know 6 is a zero of the function, or x minus 6 is a factor, the remainder here should be 0. Let's go ahead and give it a try. We bring down the 1 and start multiplying by 6. 1 times 6 is 6. And we add negative 6. Negative 6 times 6 is negative 36. And we add, this would be positive 13. 13 times 6 is 78. This is good news. Notice our remainder is 0. And this quotient also gives us our degree 2 factor of the original function. This 1 represents the coefficient of the x squared term. So the other factor would be x squared minus 6x plus 13. And again, we're looking for the x values that make this function equal to 0. Well, we already found the 0 from this factor. Now we want to find the 0 from this quadratic factor. Let's go ahead and find the zeros of this on the next slide. So we're going to set x squared minus 6x plus 13 equal to 0. Unfortunately, this is not factorable, and we know that because we only have one real rational 0. So to find the zeros here, we'll have to use the quadratic formula, which I put up here just in case for review. So we should recognize that a is equal to 1, b is equal to negative 6, and c is equal to positive 13. So again, applying the quadratic formula, we're going to have x equals negative negative 6 plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, negative 6 squared minus 4 times 1 times 13 all over 2 times a, and a is 1. So now let's go ahead and simplify this. We're going to have positive 6 plus or minus the square root of, you need to be careful simplifying underneath the square root. This number here is called the discriminant. It would be positive 36 minus, this would be 52. Well, 36 minus 52 is equal to negative 16. So the number underneath the square root here is negative 16, and our denominator is just 2. Now let's continue simplifying. We have 6 plus or minus, well, the square root of negative 16 is equal to the square root of negative 1 times 16. The square root of negative 1 is equal to I. The square root of 16 is 4. So we have 6 plus or minus 4i divided by 2. Now this does simplify, but you need to be careful here. We cannot just simplify the 6 and the 2 here because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. So my suggestion here to avoid an error is to break this up into two fractions. We have 6 divided by 2 plus or minus 4i divided by 2. Well, 6 divided by 2 is 3, and of course 4 divided by 2 is 2, so we have 3 plus or minus 2i. Notice how the two remaining zeros are complex zeros. Now going back to our previous slide, again we know one zero is x equals 6. We know another zero is now x equals 3 plus 2i, and the other zero is x equals 3 minus 2i, which again we could have written as just 3 plus or minus 2i as we had on the previous slide. So these would be the three zeros to the given degree 3 polynomial function. Okay, I hope this helps.